Welcome to Learning Equinox. In our last video on banking literacy, we talked about the different types of checks that can be issued. Hope you have watched this video and now you have a fair idea of the checks that can be issued. I shall leave you here with a link in the iCard as well as somewhere in the description box for you to watch that video. Today we shall talk a bit more about this negotiable instrument. Many a times we are asked to submit a cancel check. In our last video, we also made a mention of it, but there were a few things that we must note while canceling a check. What are they? How should it be canceled? And a lot more. Further, many a times we would want to make a stop payment on a check that is issued. How and when does this situation arise? How to stop a check and what are its consequences? All of this is what we shall look into in this video today. Before we begin, I hope by now you have had a fair idea of the kind of educational series that we have been engaging into. Financial literacy is an important aspect of education and we must equip our children about this topic. So if you feel that your idea resonates with that of mine, then do comment and let me know how you find these series on banking literacy. I would suggest you stay connected with us at Learning Equinox by subscribing to our channel. Also, do not forget to hit onto the bell notification so that you get notified every single time we upload our videos. Watch this video till the end to get a glimpse of the impact of the Negotiable Instrument Act on two types of instrument, the cancelling of a check and stopping of a check. So let's get started with this. Firstly, we shall look at cancellation of a check. How to cancel a check and what do you need in case of a cancel check? When all other situations that you need to cancel a check? So let's look at this. Firstly, we'll look at how to cancel a check. In our earlier video, we have already talked about cancellation of a check. We mentioned that simple drawing of two lines across the check by placing the word cancelled in between them is the right way to cancel a check, as you can see on the screen. Besides this, there are a few things that you must keep in mind while cancelling a check. Firstly, do not sign a cancelled check. It's important because this can be misused. Secondly, use your own pen to cancel the check to avoid frauds. Many a times with the intent to do fraud, someone may request you to cancel a check with their pen. This may be of an erasable ink. So it is best that you do not sign the check with anybody else's pen, but use your own pen to cancel a check. This way you will remain safe from check frauds. Now let's look at the next aspect. When do you need to cancel a check? So there could be a situation where, you know, bank needs to deduct EMI from your account. In such a situation, you would need to cancel a check. Second one could be if you are purchasing any consumer durable goods on installments. In such a situation also, you may be called to give a cancel check to, so that the EMIs can be deducted from your account. In case of opening of a DMAT account also, a cancel check may be required. For purchase of mutual fund and withdrawal of provident fund are other situations where a cancel check may be required. Basically, anywhere you need to give bank details, the person may ask you for a cancel check. For example, you're giving your flat on rent, the tenant may ask you a cancel check so that he can deposit the, so that he can have the account details and he can deposit it in your account, the rent that you have to receive. So now let us move on to the next part, which is about a stop check. So as you can see on the screen, a check that is normally issued, which you have already issued, you can go ahead and stop that. But this stopping of a check can happen only before it is encashed. So what are such situations where you may want to stop a check? Let's look at that. If in case you have to make a payment of some good or service you did not receive, that means you have not received that particular service or that goods, in such a situation, you may want to stop the payment. Second case could be in case there is no sufficient balance in your account. Now, in this case also, you can issue a stop pay. If the check here gets presented, it will bounce back. So bouncing of a check is a punishable offense. So to avoid such a situation, you can pay the check, you can issue a stop pay on the check and inform the party accordingly to whom you have issued the instrument not to present it for payment. The third situation could be in case you've already made payment via some other mode like NEFT or IMPS or a credit card payment or any other mode. In such case, if you've already earlier issued the check, you may want to stop the payment for that to avoid duplication. So in such case, you may want to use a stop check feature. How can you stop a check? Let's look at that as well. This you can do through net banking, mobile banking, ATM, customer care. There's an IVR option where you can go ahead and stop a check, or simply by visiting a bank branch. All you need is a check number to be mentioned for the process of stop payment through any of these modes. There is a nominal fee charged by the bank, so the bank will debit that stop payment service fee, which gets debited from your account. So hope this explains the significance of a stop check and a cancel check. These are done in our day-to-day lives, and it's important for us to know the small things to save ourselves, and thus we try to cover these two types of check in this video. If you've liked this video, do give it a thumbs up and share it around with others so that you know the significance of negotiable instruments. That's all for today. In our coming videos, we shall be talking on other modes of payment as well, like RTGS, IMPS, NEFT, and a lot more. Hope you are by now connected with us by subscribing to our channel. If not, please do not forget to subscribe to Learning Equinox, and we shall keep feeding you with useful knowledge. Do not forget to hit on the bell notification to get notified every single time we upload our videos. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more.